is going to unleash them for us. Please join me in welcoming Anxo Pérez.
All right. All right, well, good morning, everybody. You can do better than that. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Actually, it was good afternoon. All right, so are y'all getting ready to have some fun today, yes or no?
Yes.
Are you sure? Are you ready?
Yes.
Well, Simon, thank you for that introduction. I'm going to do the talk in English. I'll speak a little bit of Spanish later on, maybe. But I'll try to do the talk in English. Maybe if you can give me, si me podéis poner un poquito de luz en el público para poder ver las caras del público, os lo agradezco. Flor, si me ayudas tú. All right. I was told by the organizers, Florencia and Alex and Simon, they told me that today I might have before me, thank you, gracias. I might have before me the most interactive audience in the world. Is that true or not true? You sure? Can we do a test?
Yes!
Thank you to the 14 people that said yes. Can we do a test, yes or no?
Yes!
All right, I'm gonna leave the stage, and then I'm gonna come back on, and you guys have to make noise. You know what noise is? Can we do a test? First, stomp your feet. Louder, 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 louder. All right. And then when I say go, everybody stand up and you just scream. Okay, and you will know how to do this because we have a song with us and it's a very famous song. And you all know this song and you're gonna love this song. And if you don't love this song, you have a problem. Okay, are you ready, yes or no?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna leave the stage. When I come back on, first stomp your feet, then we make noise, then we stand up, and then we make a lot of noise. They gotta hear us in Finisterre, which is where I'm from. All right, you ready, yes or no?
Yes.
I can't hear you. You ready, yes or no?
Yes.
All right. Let me hear your feet. All right. Hands, hands, hands. Yeah. When you say clap, they stay still. So if you find them, you just point at them, okay? Not now, but if it happens, you just make sure we all know, you know, so that we can show, you know, where he can get some coffee out there, you know, or something. So this is the thing. We're going to be talking today about the mentality of success. We're not going to be talking about technology as much as you think. We're not going to be talking about numbers, not figures. I'll let somebody else do that. But we will be talking about the mentality of success. We're going to be talking about the 21st century companies. Not in terms of how to make a lot of money, that's the byproduct, but in terms of mentality. So many of you, most of you have lived in both centuries. A few of you haven't. I've only lived in this century. And you saw that there used to be a way to bring about leadership in the 20th century. And our parents and our grandparents, you know, we love them to death. They did as best as they could. But sometimes that way of leadership was a bit obsolete. We're going to leave it aside. And we're going to learn how to We're going to see how we can do things different in the 21st century. By the way, everything I'm going to be sharing today, I have done wrong for a long time, okay? And I have learned to improve, and you know, you got to learn to be humble, you got to learn that sometimes you make mistakes, and that's fine too, that's fine too. So everything I'm going to be sharing today are seven mistakes I made, and how not to make them, how you should not do the same thing that I did. So that's what I'll be sharing. I am, well, I've heard there's a lot of people from different countries. Est-ce qu'il y a des gens ici qui peuvent parler français? Vous êtes d'où? Ah. Je vous vois pas, il y a des gens ici qui peuvent parler français. Peut-être que vous pouvez me dire bonjour.
Bonjour.
Amazing. E forse dove sono gli italiani? Dove sta l'italiano? Cioè, and why are the Italian people, they always talk with their hands? Well, I don't understand. You come to Italy, you talk to la mia mamma, you eat the pizza, you love the country. Oh. Of course. You see, you're here, you speak Italian, huh? Vielleicht gibt es hier Leute, die auf Deutsch sprechen können. Wo seid ihr? Also, alles gut? Alles klar. Alles gut? Trilingual. Amazing. Мне очень нравится русский язык. Кто говорит по-русски? О, я подумал, что никто не говорит по-русски. Где вы? А здесь? Хорошо, хорошо. Самый красивый, да? Конечно. We're not gonna translate that. We're not gonna translate that. Onde está a gente que fala português? Eu sabia que ele estava lá. Eu tenho sotaque do Brasil. As minhas desculpas. Desculpa. Tenho sotaque do Brasil. O espanhol que está em Valência fala português e sotaque do Brasil. Não perguntem. Tá bom? Então vocês têm que falar: olá, tudo bem? Tem que dizer: tudo ótimo. Olá, tudo bem?
Tudo ótimo.
Tudo ótimo. All right. Quadrilingual by now. And now you have to concentrate. This is really difficult for some people. 我觉得汉语非常有用。如果你们想学汉语，中国人在哪里？ That was an Italian guy speaking Ni Hao in Chinese. That was not Chinese. All right. So you guys are all polyglots. So big round of applause to you guys, amazing. Welcome. All right. So I am a language fanatic, right? I learned to speak 9 languages, not because I'm very smart, but because I created a methodology. It's called 8 Bells. Many of you, if you're from Spain, you might know it. I created a methodology that allows any person to learn a language in eight months. And it was very difficult. We did something really crazy, and that was I'll tell you a bit more about it later, but we basically created the first ranking worldwide, you know, about the human genome, basically figured out the human system. A lot of work, but you only do it one time. We did the same thing. We mapped out a language by ranking every single word according to the frequency of use. The words that you use very frequently, they went up in this ranking. And those that you don't use that frequently, they go down in the ranking. It took us 40,000 hours. It was crazy. Today we would have done it faster. But it took forever. But it allowed any person to learn a language really quickly. This allowed us to go up really quickly. We grew 400% the first year, 400% second year, third year, fourth year, 400% every time. Then it stabilized. And then came the mistakes. And then I made a lot of mistakes. I was the founder of the company. We ended up having 300 employees. But again, I made several mistakes, and I'd like to share them with you. I'm going to tell you today one principle that has changed my life. I've learned 9 languages, and I've learned to play 9 musical instruments by using this technique. And I'd be glad to share it with you guys. And it's gonna be brief, I'm not gonna make it lengthy, but if you use this technique, and by the way, you should share this with your family, share it with your kids. You know, if you want them to go faster in school, you're gonna tell them this technique. I call it, it's the technique that I used to create this company, okay? So, and it's a secret in order to learn anything in a tenth of the time, right? A fraction of the time. So if you want to learn faster this weekend, apply this technique. If you want to do better in your business, learn more knowledge, apply this technique. And I call it the Gandhi face theory. The Gandhi face theory. You're like, why did you pick Mahatma Gandhi? I don't know. I like the guy. I don't know. You know, he nothing against the British, but he beat the British Empire with glasses and a diaper. So I thought that was pretty remarkable. So anyway, so I picked this face, a very easy to recognize face. And this is what the principle says. Anytime you analyze the information, you will learn that the value of the information is not all equal, it's all unequal. Unequal. What does that mean? There's a bit of the information that is worth 10, and a lot of the information that is worth 1. It happens all the time. Okay? Sometimes I don't have a piano here today, but often I'll do a lecture with a piano, and I'll show the audience how you can actually learn how to play 1,000 songs on the piano in less than an hour. You're like, is there a trick? There is a trick. The trick is that you only learn one song, but what you learn with one, you can apply it to 1,000. And you can do that within an hour. And we've done it before, we've done it with people. And it's by applying this principle. So you're gonna learn that the information is not equal, it's all unequal. When somebody's able to play that, you know, 1,000 songs on the piano within an hour, is because there's a lot of information that they do not know. They leave out. And this is the key. You have to leave out useless information. People make a mistake all the time. They wanna learn a language or whatever, they're like, hey, the more I know, the better for me. Wrong. The more you know, the less you will remember. So you want to do the other way around. You want to find less information, but you got to know it better. So imagine that we have this picture, Mahatma Gandhi, and we want to turn this picture into a puzzle. There's two ways to build a puzzle. One would be to start on one of the corners, and you add one piece of the puzzle, and then another piece, and another piece, and another piece. If you could only add one piece every day, and there's an audience here, and we want for the audience to know what the puzzle is about, and you're only seeing this part, the audience would be like, I don't know what it's about. I know it's about a blue sky. That's all I know about the puzzle. So that's the worst way, the least intelligent way to build a puzzle. What would be the smartest way? What do you think? What's this? Glasses? What do you think is the smartest way?
The nose.
The nose, exactly. The glasses, the nose, the face, exactly. You start with the nose, and with a lot less pieces, you have a lot more information. So what does this mean? Every time you learn whatever it is, it could be with a language, but you could apply this to anything. All the pieces of the puzzle have the same size. They even have the same cost. If you had to buy them, they cost the same. It costs the same to buy a blue piece of the sky as it does to buy a piece of the face. And yet, same effort, same cost, completely different results. Completely different results. This applies to companies. I've been studying companies. Why are there some companies that grow really, really fast? You know why? Because they found the Gandhi face. They found the Gandhi face. And they know what to invest their time, their effort. If any of you out there really, really busy, has any of you ever sent an email after 8 p.m., after 9 p.m., after 10 p.m., after 11 p.m., workaholic, all right? Then it's not that you have too many tasks to do, you have too many tasks to cancel. You have to cancel more tasks. You have to learn what to discard, what to leave out. Why? Because those are the blue pieces of the sky, and they provide nothing, and you have to find them. So if somebody's really busy, what would I do is that I sit with you, and we're gonna start making a list of all the tasks that you have to not complete, and you have to leave them out. And when you do that, the company actually goes out. So what we did is with my company, was it all a bed of roses? And the answer is, of course not. Of course not. It was so difficult. I mean, again, you know, I had no mentor at the beginning, and I really felt lonely. It was difficult. It was a difficult task to build a company on your own, and whatever. But it was. So the saying goes, don't let them tell you it's easy. That's a lie. But don't let them tell you it's not worth it, because that is also a lie. That's also a lie. So it's gonna be hard. Yeah, I know it's gonna be hard. And in your field, man, welcome to the roller coaster. Is it like that or not? It's okay. But if there's a big fluctuation, there's a big opportunity for profit. It goes like that. It always is like that. And we're gonna be talking about today. So these are the 7 mistakes that you cannot make, that I have made, that you cannot make. Error number 7. You beat yourself up during the crisis period. So there's a crisis, and let's call it wave. There's a huge wave. The wave is good or is it bad? What do you think? Huge wave, is it good or is it bad? Giant wave. Hey, I like this guy. Give me your phone number afterwards. Smart man. It depends where you are. If you're a surf lover and you're on top of the wave, you love the wave. But if you're below the wave, it's the energy that is going to kill you. So the same energy, and this is important, it's the same energy, but it's a different use. Same energy, different use. Some people use it to go up, some people use it to go down. So this is the phrase that you're going to repeat yourself. Next time there's a crisis, you got to remember this phrase, this sentence that I'm going to put on the screen. And I know you're going to think I'm a little bit crazy, but you're going to give it a chance. Okay, you're going to give it a chance. And this works for everything in your own life. When your couple breaks up with you, remember this. And it goes like this. Your partner says, hey, I don't want to go on. It's like, this is the phrase. This. Today you can't understand it, but... Sorry, New York, you can't do vacation rentals now. You're going to make it very difficult. But I have a lot of apartments in New York. I'm not sure I like this law. Well, you repeat the sentence. Your partner wants to go away, you repeat the sentence. Your child says that he's getting kicked out of school because he's been skipping school for 2 weeks. You repeat the sentence. You can't understand it today, but this is the best thing that could have ever happened to you. That's it. So one time we're in the company, and our company, this is the high season for us. We teach languages in Spain, in Northern Hemisphere. The school season starts in September, so people think about learning languages in September, October. And this was in August, a few years back, and our head of sales says, I'm leaving. And my right-hand man, he comes shaking like this. He's like, Anxo, you're not going to believe me. The head of sales, he is gone. Right before the high season. And he was so nervous, he was so scared. And I looked him in the eye and I said, well, this is the best thing that could have ever happened to us. He was like, are you sure? I was. And I was like, yeah, I'm sure. He was like, why? It's like, because something's gonna happen in a month. Okay, what's gonna happen in a month? I'm like, I have no idea. How do you know it's good? It's like, because it never is bad. You don't hire somebody else to make it worse than the previous guy, right? You don't go into a new episode to make it worse than the previous episode. Yeah, but you can make a mistake, he said. I said, you sure can. But every time you make a mistake, it's like turning the cards and trying to find the ace. If you turn more cards, the chances of finding the cape, of finding the ace, do they go up or do they go down? What do you think? They go up. So the more shots you take, the bigger the chances. And of course, that was the best thing that could have ever happened to us. We hired somebody else, and then the company went a lot better. So error number 6, what should we learn how to do? We should learn how to manage crises. And you know what? Listen to this. There is only one place in the world where suffering comes from. Only one place. Suffering doesn't come from illness, doesn't come from death, doesn't come from bankruptcy, doesn't come from betrayal. It only comes from one place, and it's called the human mind. Somebody that's in a coma is not suffering. You can't suffer without your mind. You got pain, you got physical pain, but you can't have suffering. Suffering is a mental thing. So what's error number 6? And this was my biggest mistake, maybe. I wrote my first book here in Spain, and it became the number one bestseller in Spain. I didn't expect it. Nobody expected it. It was something we didn't expect. And it was all about how to make more money. It was all about outer success. Outer success. And one day, I learned that I was making a mistake. And I said, you know what? Dude, why would you want all the success in the world on the outside if you have no success on the inside? And that was me. I don't know if many of you guys are here, but I woke up and I was worried. I go to lunch, I was worried. I go to dinner, I was worried. Go back to bed and I was worried. I was addicted to worrying. I was an addict. Workaholic, like some of you guys, except that my emails were at 1 a.m. okay, 1 a.m. And I was addicted to work, I was addicted to worry. And I didn't know how to do it. And my books talked about success, 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 but it was all outer success. And one day, it was 2018, life gave me a gift. So are you ready to test my gift, yes or no? The most interactive audience in the world is ready to do. Are you ready, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, this is called the aha moment, okay? And this is the guy that comes with me to every lecture I do. It's called the brick banging moment. Okay, are you guys all ready to do that? This is what life gives you, a brick banging moment in your head. You're like, wake up, Anxo, wake up. So are you ready to do the brick moment?
Yes.
This is how it goes. You gotta do your left hand out. Not that left, but the other left. And then the right hand up, like sort of like an L shape. And when I say 3, 2, 1, well, first you have to find the boycotter. Is the boycotter there or not? The person boycotting the conference, are they there? Well, is today an exception or not? Wow, you hit me today, good. So when I say 3, they have to hear it's in Singapore, okay? And when I say boom, okay? 3, 2, 1, boom! All right, and this is what life said. Life got brick, gave me a brick banging moment in the head, and I had like an awakening experience, 2018. And I realized that everything I've been doing was like crap. I was not doing very well. I thought I was smart, I wasn't smart. I thought I was successful, I was not successful. I was a failure because I was a failure on the inside. And you know, and it was good. It was good for, it's good for vanity. It's good, you know, because vanity goes down. It's good for humility because, and you become more coachable. I wasn't very coachable, really. I mean, I don't know, whatever. So the mistake number 6 is not investing in inner success. Not investing in inner success. You want to be a 21st century company, you're going to have to be a conscious company. Millennials and Gen X and all these guys coming next, they don't want companies that just make money. Nobody wants them anymore. Money has to be the byproduct. But you have to be an integrous and conscious company. Because the new generations don't want the other type of companies anymore. Those companies are gone. So there's an author whom I love. His name is David Hawkins. He's an American author, psychiatrist. And he came up with a scale. It's called Map of Consciousness or the Scale of Consciousness. And in this scale of consciousness, he said that all of us, there's a scale from 0 points to 1,000 points, and we are all on this scale somewhere. And you can figure out what your number is. You know, I could probably tell you today if you want me to tell you. And there's a number that tells you where your level of consciousness is. And there are 3 critical points. 200, right here. This separates what goes against life than what goes in favor of life. Okay, and this applies to companies too. Second level is 500, is when you start, when you go beyond the mind. I was like a mathematician, you know, ones and zeros. I created the algorithm for my company. You know, I was like a lab rat, you know, just there, ones and zeros. If my mind couldn't understand it, I would say I'm not interested. I was that stupid. So I couldn't understand this. I couldn't understand the level of love. And when we say love, it's not like the love songs, I love you today, you're with me, I hate you tomorrow, you're with somebody else. Okay, that's not love, that's called attachment. That has nothing to do with love. Love is something else. Worrying is lack of love. Regretting the past is lack of love. When you are with love, you are in the present moment. And you learn to accept unconditional acceptance, and you learn to let go of grudges. So, and then the goal is 540. We should all try to reach this level. And again, this works for people, it works with people, and it works with companies. So you can actually measure the level of consciousness of different people in history, and I'm gonna show you some. In fact, they're alive today. Well, this guy's not alive, but the others are. So this guy, what do you think? He had a high level of consciousness or low level of consciousness? What do you think? What kind of energy do you get when you hear his music, when you heard him talk? High level of consciousness, low level of consciousness. What do you think? By the way, anytime you reach like 600 to 1,000, that's like levels of enlightenment, okay? So we're not there, okay? So the top is like 600, okay? Gandhi was higher and a few others, but not many. So his level of consciousness was extremely high, 592 at the time of his death, okay? Very high. Keanu Reeves, what do you think, is high or low? This guy's a great guy, he's a great guy. Yeah, he's a great guy. His level of consciousness is pretty high, 522. And Shakira, what do you think? She was good, but then she wrote this song against Piqué and then she went down. She was doing okay, you know, but then, you know, she was loving him for a little while, and then like, all right, I'm gonna love you less and less and less, and then, well, 270. Actually, we checked her recently and it was a bit lower, but whatever, let's keep her there. So she's still above the 200 level, which is critical. And then I have a very, sexy man. He likes to ride the horses. Very, very sexy man. You know him, I like him very much. He's very nice man, okay? Okay, so Putin was not very low, he was higher. But then, you know, something happened and it went down, okay? And it went down to 70, so not very high. But we don't judge anybody, you know? Yes, sir. You measure this with, there was a question that said, how do you measure this? You measure this through kinesiology. If you check online, there's videos, there's a lot of books on kinesiology, and you can, or if you catch me at the coffee break afterwards, maybe I can show you. Okay, so it works with people, but it also works with corporations. And this is the 21st century. So we want people to be as high as possible. We want corporations to be as high as possible. And you'll see that there's a huge correlation, and this is amazing. By the way, you can do this with countries as well. Africa, for example, we love Africa, but Africa right now, because of a lot of dictators, is very, very low, below 100. A lot of African countries, not all of them. Haiti is very low. And countries like Norway, Japan, Switzerland are very high, okay? Spain is at 309 right now, 309. With the Catalonian conflict, it went down a little bit. So, corporations, listen to this. You'll see a correlation. You're gonna see a very, very nice correlation. How well is doing Apple business-wise? Extremely well. Not long ago was the richest company in history, now Amazon maybe. Okay, 530, extremely high. It's not very common to see companies that calibrate at 530, very high. It's basically love for the product, love for the people, love for the company, love for the customers. And does that mean they make no mistakes? No, of course they'll make a lot of mistakes, but it's a very high level. Walmart, we don't have many Walmarts in Europe, but you probably know Walmart. And 470, the level of the founder was also very high. Spotify, a bit lower, but still very integrous, higher than the level of Spain, for example. 320 Spotify. And then you have companies, Nokia, we checked the level of Nokia when Nokia started going down. Not right now, maybe right now it's higher, but you know, Nokia was the number one in the world and lost, you all know the story, and then lost that ascendancy, that position of power. And at that time, it was 100. 100 means very, very low level of consciousness. It means that there's fear. There's fear in the company, lots of fear. In fact, 100 is called level of fear. And then you know who this guy is? There was a TV show on Netflix by Robert De Niro playing him. Very fascinating story. It was the biggest Ponzi scheme in the world. And he basically stole, indirectly, $63 billion. $63 billion, if I'm not mistaken. So Bernie Madoff. So not very good, level 9. No consciousness. No level of consciousness. Very, very non-integrous. It's, by the way, level 9 is very close to death. 0 is death, same thing. And you know, you all know the story of Enron. You guys know of Enron? Am I too old or what? You guys know Enron, right? Have you guys seen September 11th, 2001? You remember that day? Okay, good, I'm feeling old, okay. Enron number 2. So basically you have death, you have amoeba, and then you have Enron. Not good. And what happened to Enron? So I call this my company is called 8 Belts for the languages, and I use the same method. Well, why is it called 8 Belts? Because in the when you learn a language, you know, it's like martial arts. You can be belt 1, belt 2, belt 3, whatever. And that works for languages, when you learn a language in our system. It also works for inner success. So you can have a belt 1, or you can have a belt 2, 3, 4, or you can be belt 5, 6, 7, or 8. What happens in your life, and you know these people, you know people like this, you know companies like this. What happens in your life when you have somebody with a belt 8 There's very, very little unsettledness or perturbance. Unsettledness. And when you have a belt one, you can call it suffering. That's easy, okay? So there's a lot of suffering, very little suffering, okay? Somebody says, man, you just ran into my car. You bumped, you know, bumper to bumper. I can't believe you were watching, you were looking, you're so stupid. What would be the belt of that person? One. But you've probably seen other people that, you know, somebody rear ends you and you say, oops, well, I can't believe this happened. Well, let's exchange, you know, insurance information. Hey, wait, aren't you the guy that was at my kid's school the other day? Like, yeah. Oh, man, I meant to say hi after the game. We couldn't say hi. How beautiful that now we have a chance to meet each other. Hey, my name is Anxo. Great to meet you. And whatever you may need, you know? And now he runs out. It was supposed to be an accident. And now he has a new friend. How could that be? It's called level of consciousness. That guy calibrates high for sure, extremely high. And you see this with bosses. You see this with companies. You see this with people everywhere. You know them. Your cousins, your, you know, people that look small, maybe they're a meter 55. He has a giant inside. He's always smiling. He's happy. He knows how to handle crises. You know, and then you've seen the others. Maybe he's 2 meters tall. And the minute somebody does this on the highway, they lose their temper. Fly off the handle. Amazing, yes or no? You know them, yes or no? You know any belt 8, 7 out there? Any 7? You know any belt 7s out there? Do you know belt 1s? Those are easier to find. Those are easier to find. They seem to be everywhere. Right, so look at this. Beautiful. Life is like a mirror. When your company improves the world improves your company. It's a mirror. It's a mirror. Those companies had a high level of consciousness. They tried to do the right thing. And then it just so happens that the universe rewards you somehow. Minds sometimes can't not really understand it, but it works fine. Everything's in synchronization. Error number 5, not knowing how to raise your belt. We should all raise our belts in our companies. We should all do this. And we should invest time and money in raising our belt within our company. We should all do this. And by the way, I've done it. My company was not very high. It used to calibrate at 280 at one point. I mean, it's not horrible, but it wasn't very good. And again, I made a lot of mistakes, and I wasn't doing my job, and I don't know. And then, little by little, we started pouring love into the company. And when I say love, it's like, hey, how can we be... I remember one time, the CEO of the company, the president, and she said, hey, I'm going to tell everybody that, you know, something happened, and she had to become CEO within 3 hours. We learned at 11 that by 3 p.m. she had to be the new CEO. And I was like, well, don't tell everybody you're the new CEO. Right now, tell them that you've been planning on this for 3 months. Yeah, I'm going to lie. And she said, I'm not going to do that. I said, why not? I said, because it's not the truth. And I was like, yeah, but what are people going to think? It's like, it doesn't matter. What do you want? A company that has a high level of consciousness or a low level of consciousness? Oh, I want it high. If you want it high, then... Florencia, unas tijeras imposibles. If you want a company that calibrates really high, then do things that are in coherence with a company that calibrates really high. This is what she told me. Oh, like, man. Like, thank you, life. Another brick banging moment. And I'm like, all right, let's go for it. Let's go for it. And so she did. So the way to go up in your belt is this. Somebody asks you, hey, where did that thought come from? And what do you say? The last thought you had, where did it come from? Your mind, okay. Or where did that desire to punch that driver that cut you off in traffic come from? Where did it come from? Thank you. Beautiful. Big round of applause for these people that are producing manifest things out of nowhere. Where did that come from? And you say the inside, good. I like her. Are you from Denmark too? It comes from the inside. She says it came from the inside. Where did the thought come from? Inside. The desire to punch Donald Trump, where did it come from? It came from the inside, okay? Okay. But we talk about the inside as if it was one place. It's not. And I'm going to tell you. So this is the thing. Anytime you put yourself up, the world brings you down. And anytime you put yourself down, the world brings you up. So what does that mean? Is that you have to be coherent. If you want a high company, you have to make high decisions. If you want a low company, you make low decisions. So this is the scissor principle, and it talks about coherence. And I made this mistake, of course, for a long time. So there is not one place on the inside, there are two. Are you ready for the, ready for the brick moment? Everybody with me? Where's the boycotter? Where's the boycotter? I can smell you. All right, 3, 2, 1, boom! It's not one spot, it's two spots. This is my friend that travels with me everywhere I go. It's called Mr. Me. Why is it Mr. Me? Because it could be any of us. And he has three elements. He has the black bag, and he has the white bag. The black bag represents negativity. The white bag represents the light. We all have the negativity, the shade, the shadow inside of us. But we all have the light too. Hey man, that email that you sent was horrible, and it's made us lose a lot of money. You are a bad employee. What color bag is that? Black bag or white bag? What do you think? Black bag, yes. The other day I was doing a speech and somebody said, hey, are you racist, man? Why is the black always bad? It's like, man, I'm not, and I said, it's not my fault that darkness is dark. What can I say, man? I'm not racist. And so I said, that was a black bag. You come home and your kid, he skipped school for 2 weeks. You're like, come here, son. I'm really upset. And you're going to know it. What color bag is that? Black bag, white bag? Black bag. But listen to this. Everything that we do as leaders in our company, in our lives, from the black bag, we can do from the white bag. Any single thing. Listen to this. If you go to the gym out of fear to get fat, what color is that? It's black. You do it out of fear. But you can change that. You say, hey, I don't go to the gym out of fear to get fat. I go to the gym out of love to get healthy. Same exercise, completely different energy. Completely different energy. You talk to somebody, hey, don't ever send that email again because it's made us lose a lot of money. And if you do that, you are perpetuating darkness. Change it. And we can learn how to do that. So how do we raise our level of consciousness? Very easy. Just ask yourself one question before you talk to any employee, you talk to your kids, you talk to your wife, to your husband. Just ask one question. And it's this thing that I'm about to tell you, out of where? Where from am I saying it? Where from? Am I saying it from the black bag or am I saying it from the white bag? And just the fact that you asked that question, the simple question of that question automatically makes it white. That's it. Because you're becoming aware. You're not being asleep anymore. So, and by the way, this is not in the script, but I'm going to say it anyway. If there's any sort of crisis in your field, any sort of bad news, new laws, regulations that you don't like, if you're fearful of losing your business, before you do anything, before you make any phone calls and you're all frantic, just please do this. This is called the pendulum. And when there's fear, the pendulum is shaking, okay? Shaking a lot. And whenever there is anger, the pendulum is shaking a lot. Shaking a lot. And whatever you do while your pendulum is shaking is going to be a Black. So please, when you have your pendulum like that, you're going to do one thing. You go to your room, you go to your office, or you go to the bathroom. I don't care. And you just breathe a little bit. And you breathe 10 times. And you picture that you're going down a ladder that has 10 steps. Close your eyes and you just do this. And there's a miracle that happens. Every time that you breathe, picturing yourself going down this ladder, the level of the pendulum, the intensity of the pendulum goes down. Amazing. It's amazing. And when it gets to zero, the level of the pendulum is zero. And then you send whatever email you want to send. I've done this so many times, it saved my life. It saved my life. My level of stress was so high. It used to be so high. You know, I even had a lot more weight. It was just not healthy. And just by breathing, and by the way, I do this all the time. I'm talking like more than 10 times a day, more than 20 times a day. I do it all the time. And just by breathing, it changes your life. So error number four, hating uncertainty. Sorry, your business will have uncertainty. Deal with it. And learn how to love it. Learn to love it. In 5 years from now, everything you know will be worthless. So what? All the tools that you have today, in a year from now, will be worthless. So what? You have to be on top. And by the way, make sure that you're next to the smartest people. Smartest tools, smartest companies. That's not a mistake I made. So learn to love uncertainty. It doesn't matter. It's not a big deal. There's uncertainty. Okay, so what? Learn to love it. And it doesn't have to be a reason to put yourself down. Frustration is the same seed which is common both to people that abandon the course and to people that make it to the top. Same thing. Your son comes home, or daughter. Dad, I am so frustrated, I'm quitting school. But he or she has a twin brother, a twin sister. And the twin sister comes and like, hey dad, I'm so frustrated, I'm gonna study twice as hard. Same thing, same seed. You use the frustration in two different ways. It's up to you. So you can say, hey man, this field is full of uncertainty. I'm gonna go to a different field. Okay, go, there's the door, man. That's okay, maybe you're not cut out for this. That's fine. But if you wanna stay in this field, you love uncertainty, and it's not a problem, you embrace change. And whenever somebody tells you there is a new way of doing things, you listen. And you don't say, no, but you know, I'm used to the old way. Don't do that. When I was mapping out the language, I had an employee, and I told her how to, you know, be a lot faster. She's like, no, but look, I do this other way. I've been doing it for a long time. And it took me like months before I could get her to change the mindset. And I didn't understand how people, you know, it's very difficult for human beings to embrace change. And we have to learn to love change. It's part of life, and it's actually your friend, not your enemy. Error number three, to be a toxic leader. I was a toxic leader sometimes. I wasn't horrible, but, you know, lots of room for improvement. This story that I'm going to tell you today is a story that I've told everywhere. I've done this, you know, I even did a speech in Kazakhstan, half in Russian, half in English. You know, in Latin America, everywhere. And I always tell this story. It's one of my favorite stories. It's a true story. I used to be an interpreter, like these guys over here that are doing such a great job. Maybe we can give them a round of applause. That was my job. That's what I would do. I would be up there in the cabins like these guys are. And that was my previous job. And then I started a company and things changed for me, but that's what I used to do. So, and I was his interpreter. I was this guy's interpreter. He was the grandson of Mahatma Gandhi. He was quite a prominent figure in India. And he told me this amazing story. Listen to this story. You're gonna tell this story. When you remember this speech, you won't remember anything but this story. Okay, you're gonna go home, you're gonna tell this story. And the black bag and the white bag. And the pendulum. Okay? But you're gonna remember this story. You're gonna tell this story to your family. True story. One time, Mahatma Gandhi, one of the biggest figures of the 20th century, says, hey, Arun, that was his name, Arun, you come. Well, he said it like this, Arun, you come up with me on Saturday to the city. Okay, this is how he did it. You know, Mahatma Gandhi. This is my impersonation of Mahatma Gandhi. You're going to be with me all morning in the morning, and we're going to be sharing all day, and then you're going to have to go home. Simon, did I do good? Was that pretty good? He says, okay, no problem. He said, and in the afternoon, you're going to go to your aunt and uncle's house. But it's very important that at 5:15, you be at the pickup place. Don't be late. He said, Grandpa, don't worry about it. I'll be there. So he goes to his aunt and uncle's house, and then he sees a big sign that says, movie theater. And so he gets into the movie theater, loses track of time. The movie ends at 6:15. He's like, oops. So what am I going to do now? So he's like, starts running like crazy. His heart's racing. He's like, oh man, what am I going to tell my grandfather now? I got to make up something. So comes back and says, Grandpa, I know you're pissed. He didn't say that word. I know you're angry. But don't worry, there's a good reason why this happened. I was at our aunt and uncle's house, and they invited me to stay for dessert. And of course, I couldn't say no. You know how that goes, man. Except that he was so unlucky that Mahatma Gandhi had already talked to his aunt and uncle. Knew he was lying like crazy. He looked at the kid and says, Dear grandson, you're lying to me. So you are lying. And there are only two ways to look at the situation. Number one is to conclude that you did not behave right. And the second way is to conclude that I did not raise you well. And of course, I conclude the second. So this is what we're going to do. You're going to ride in the car to go back home. And I'm going to walk in order to reflect what I have not done right in order for this to happen. His grandson tried to keep him from doing that. You couldn't convince Mahatma Gandhi. And he walked by himself at night, barefoot. And you know the conclusion of that story is, if he would have vented his anger on his grandson, that story and that lesson would have lasted for a day. When he became responsible and owned on himself what happened, he was able to get that lesson to last for a lifetime. And I'm telling it to you guys today. So what's the phrase of this story? It's like, anytime that you put blame on someone, it's going to generate pleasure. Anytime that you don't, that will generate loyalty. So I invite you today, if you want to have a 21st century company, and I had to do this myself, I mean, I had to go through it, and it was not easy. It's a change of mind, change of heart, change of everything. I invite you today to never, ever, 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 ever point fingers anymore. Gone. You can chop your finger off if you want to. Don't point fingers at anyone. Never. Employees, customers, partners, I don't care how bad the mess up is, don't point fingers. Children, wife, husband, it doesn't matter. Don't point fingers. It's like, hey, John, I'm sorry, there was a mistake and that cost a lot of money. Can we sit down and talk? That's a white man. We're gonna talk a lot, because this is serious. I'm not saying to look the other way. We're gonna talk, but there's not gonna be blame. You're not gonna sense any energy in me that you're a sinner and you're a bad person. You're not gonna sense that, because I'm not gonna let you sense that, because you're a beautiful human being that does the best they can. And it's not my position to come and judge and make you feel small. Anytime we make somebody feel small, we're going back to the 20th century. That's not what we want. That's not the world that we want to build. Error number two. If somebody thought this was too way up in the air, let's bring it down to earth. The biggest mistake that people make that I see is to not become digital. When the lion comes, there are two groups. Who are the groups? Yes, sir. There's two groups. And by the way, what's the lion? Lion is technology. Technology is the lion, okay? And there's two groups, those that run and those that fight, okay? So, man, whatever you do, you gotta join the second team. You gotta join the second team. How many of you guys type things on your cell phone? Type things. Hey, hello, I am coming. I'm coming soon. It's okay, you can do that, but it's 20th century. You know, you can dictate. You can dictate a lot faster. You can dictate. How many of you guys say, hey, make a note at 5 p.m., I have to buy some milk? Honesty test. Thank you very much for the four honest people in the room. Okay. No! Hey, Siri, remind me at 5, I have to buy milk. 0% milk. You know, and it does it for you. It's a free secretary. Amazing, you know. Yeah, actually, but that takes adapting. Yeah, you got to try it for the first time. And you gotta fail a few times. But then it works. And guess what? When you get it forever. So this is an honesty test. How many of you guys do this? This is Spain, but I'm sure you know. You park the car on the road, then you get your coins. Well, oops, forgot that I have bills. Well, let me go change the bills. Give me the coins, put them to the machine. Hey man, 5 minutes, oops, I gotta run out, I gotta go come back out. You're out there, where are you guys? I've seen you. Thank you, honesty. I love honest people, man. Okay, that's okay. That's okay, but that's 20th century mentality. I've done that mistake, you know. There's a thing called an app, you know, and you're there in court or whatever you are, shopping center, whatever it is, and like, oh, I'm gonna extend this for 20 more minutes. You don't go anywhere. Anxo, but that takes adapting. You bet it does. Of course it does. It takes adapting. And that is 21st century mentality. You have to adapt. If you don't do it with your parking app, how are you going to do it with your whole company? You get it? You got to change your mentality. But it takes adapting. So listen to this story. Well, I'm going to skip this because otherwise. Okay, this is the thing. The placenta, right? You're in there, you know, the womb. And you love it in there, and you're like, oh man, so comfortable in here, I don't want to go anywhere. And then one day, you're like, boom! You bring that thing, and you get out, and you find out there are three things. Number one, that there is life outside. Number two, that the life outside was actually a lot bigger and better than the one inside. Man, this is a very small place. And number three, and this is the brick banging effect, is that the effort on day one is a lot. You have to break the placenta. This is when you download the app and you put your credit card in there and you learn how it works. Get it? It's a pain in the culo. Okay? But you do it. You do it, okay? Day number two, you still have to do a bit of adapting. But you still have to go pick up the app. You know, you want to go for the coin. You want to go for the coin and reach out, you know, reach for the coin. Mm. Gotta go to the app. And then you gotta adapt. Oh yeah, I got an app. Let me use the app. Not as much as day number one, but you start to adapt. Now is the brick banging moment, okay? This is the important part. What is the level of effort on day number three? Zero. What's the level of effort on day number four? Zero. Number five, zero. This is what technology does. Pay the damn price. What does that mean? Adapt. Pay the price. Yeah, it's gonna be 2 weeks and the whole company doesn't know how the system works. Sorry. You pay the price. You pay the toll. Because that's gonna make you so much better in a few weeks. Every change requires a small effort, but holds an enormous treasure. So you have to love change. You have to love change no matter what. And tell this to the people in your company. Guys, we are stupid if we don't embrace change. Because our competitors are embracing change. Otherwise, they wouldn't be competitors. They'd be gone a long time ago. And error number one, this is the worst of all mistakes. Hey, I love you guys out there, okay? But those of you that that are using the headset need to talk to me. What's the worst mistake of them all? Not knowing English. You have to speak English, man. This is 21st century. 21st century. You cannot make it in a global world without speaking English. And you talk to me about it, okay? I'll help you, don't worry. But you can't, no excuses anymore. No excuses anymore. So you have to speak English no matter what, especially in your field, okay? Information is in English. Videos are in English. Podcasts are in English. I don't care if there's a machine that translates whatever. Listen, you don't have sex through a machine, do you? Okay, with English it's the same thing. Okay, you don't bring a robot to speak English because you don't bring a robot to have sex with your wife or your husband, okay? So you want to do it yourself. You want to enjoy it yourself. So you have to be able to hold a conversation. And the importance of English is huge, even for your own jobs. There was a study here in Spain that said, in 2016, that said that those who speak English, they earn up to 32% more, okay? So think of it as an investment in your life, in your future, in your family. If you already speak English, 你好,我们应该说汉语,因为汉语非常有用. What was that one? That was not Catalan. Chinese. So you have to, you know, if you already speak English, Chinese is next, okay? Chinese is next, and that will make you different. One time the other day I got a call from this guy. I'm sure you guys know this guy. You guys know this guy? He made Spain very happy, not Germany a few years ago, but he made Spain very happy. Carlos Puyol. And he said, man, I've heard that half of Barcelona is studying with you guys, Barcelona football team. I want to learn English with you guys. And then, you know, then we taught him English, and then a few other guys. Some of the guys who are not Spanish speaking might not know these guys, but the Spanish people know these guys, right? You know these guys? Anyway, very famous singers in Spain. And so at the end of the day, if every country, all these guys were learning as well. He's one of the most famous singers in Spain, David Bisbal, and he learned English with us, even though his level was already high. He learned Chinese and he learned French. And he said, someday I'm going to do a concert in China. And someday I'm going to be doing a concert in France. And he wanted to actually be able to take questions from the audience. Anyway, so, you know, success is democratic. What do you invest in? What do you invest in? Success is democratic. You invest in knowledge, you put knowledge into your brain gives you knowledge back. If every country is a lock, every language is the key. So, global world, we have to learn languages. We have to invest in languages, no matter what. And by the way, it's never too late. Don't come telling me that you're too old. Because if you tell me that you're too old, I'll give you a speech longer than this speech, and you'll have to hear me for a long time. You're not too old, okay? And don't say, hey, yeah, my kids are gonna learn English. Don't talk to me about your kids. If you wanna learn how to play piano, you learn how to play piano. If you wanna teach your employees to be smarter employees, you become smarter. The best way to teach your child not to smoke is not by saying anything. What do you have to do? What do you have to do? Just don't smoke yourself. That's it. That speaks louder than anything. And dessert. So here we go with the dessert now. Because Florencia is going to kick me out of here soon. So dessert. We did it something crazy. We wanted today to do something crazy. Before I go on, let me say something. What these guys are doing in Avantio is not very common. You know, I do, you know, lectures everywhere and stuff. You don't see this very often. Nobody's, Alex, have you asked me to say this? No, I'm saying it because I want to say it. This is just, I'm speaking from my heart. What these guys have done here in Avantio is very crazy. It's very good. It's very good. It's not that common. So I would like to take the opportunity to thank you guys and to my gratefulness and the gratefulness of the audience. We'd like to give you a round of applause for the gentlemen. Thank you. And so we decided to do something crazy, and Mr. Alex over there, he said, oh man, let's do something different. And I was like, all right, let's do something different. Are you guys ready for the dessert? Some of you are thinking, thank you, man. Yeah. All right, Mr. Big round of applause for Mr. Alex. All right, this is called the 8 Belts Challenge. Okay.
It's the same.
How'd that go? All right, Mr. Alex. Let's see what you can do. Ni hao.
Ni hao.
Hello. Ni hao ma.
Wo hen hao.
我也很好，谢谢你。你叫什么？
我叫 Alex， 什么？
我叫 Anxo， 你是哪国人？
我是西班牙人。很好，你喜欢学习汉语吗？
我也，你喜欢学习汉语吗？是的，我喜欢学习汉语。非常好，很好。我很高兴认识你。我也很高兴认识你。好，谢谢。再见。 Este hombre, this man, too many languages now. This man couldn't speak a word of Chinese a few days back, and he was able to carry a, pretty much like a 20-minute conversation with me before we went on stage. And he did it, and he learned it in only, how many hours?
Less than 10 hours.
Less than 10 hours. He did it in less than 10 hours. So that shows that impossible is nothing. Thank you, Adidas, or was it Nike? And the only one problem, that they have no idea what we said.
So
if I say, ni hao ma, what does it mean?
Que tal? All
right, how are you? Que tal, in Spanish. If I say, ni si huan xue si han yu ma, tell me in English.
You like to speak Chinese.
Okay, and finally, if I give you a long sentence, 是的，我很高兴认识你。
I'm very pleased to meet you.
Very pleased to meet you. This guy's an amazing translator for Chinese. Hire him. Give him a round of applause. He used our platform to learn Chinese. He decided to come here on stage. That's not easy. He decided to come here on stage in front of several hundred people, and after just 10 hours of studying Chinese with our platform. So you're gonna stop saying that languages are difficult. You're gonna stop saying that the crises are a problem. It's a change of mentality. So you can take three pictures now. If you speak Spanish, you take the first picture. This is only for Spanish speakers because our platform, so far, it's only for Spanish speakers. Sorry about that. But so far, it's only for Spanish speakers. So if you're a Spanish speaker, you can take a picture of this. And by the way, this is my phone number. So you can write me a message, okay? This is the number I use. And so you just take a picture, and then you can scan that code, and you can tell me your name and the company name. And by the way, if you are from Spain, in Spain, we have something amazing, which is the, es lo voy a decir en español. I'm gonna say it in Spanish, so you guys can translate this into English. Bueno, para todos los que estéis aquí, españoles, o de habla hispana, esto es súper importante, ¿vale? No hay excusa en el siglo XXI para no aprender inglés. Esto lo digo con el corazón en la mano, ¿vale? Llevo toda la vida trabajando en esto y no hay excusa para no saber inglés. Y en España hay algo increíble, y es que si eres de una empresa, el gobierno te puede hasta pagar los cursos, ¿vale? Se llama Fundae. Esto no pasa en ningún país del mundo, en España sí. Entonces, o sea que son cursos que son beneficiados, ¿vale? Bonificados. Entonces, sacad una foto a esto, mandáis un mensaje, a veces contesto yo, a veces contesta alguien de mi equipo, y felices de ayudaros para vosotros y para vuestra empresa. Dejad de decir que es imposible el inglés, dejad de decir que es imposible aprender idiomas en el siglo XXI, ¿vale? Mentalidad de éxito, hoy nos volvamos de aquí, y algún día dentro de un año me vas a llamar, vas a decir, Anxo, yo no me lo creía, pero here I am speaking English. Así que yo estaré un ratito de todas maneras después, así que feliz de saludaros. Okay, so switch back to English for my two final pictures before I say goodbye. This is a sentence that you guys can all take home, and it says, in the world there are two types of people. Those who love talking about problems, and those who love solving. And by the way, Avantio is one of the companies from the second group, and I appreciate that. So it's a change of mentality, change of mentality, change of mentality. Well, you can give it a chance today. It's not difficult. It just takes commitment. And the final picture, these are my books. This is my contact information. I'd be glad to help you with whatever I may need. You guys have been the most interactive audience in the world.